Pancha Kaupata Rupyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We're hearing about Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, and who was given a wonderful mantra by his guru by which he could travel to many different places.
他是哥瓦丹山的一位牧牛童，他的guru给了他一首mantra，他藉着这种mantra，他旅行到了不同地方。So
with the mantra, he traveled to higher planets in the universe, and then he went beyond the universe to the abode of liberation.
他首先是旅行到了宇宙的高等星宿。
And there, he met with people from Vaikuntha, and they told him about Vaikuntha, so he was very attracted to go there. So, they told him that first you have to go back to Mathura, and then from Mathura, then you can go to Vaikuntha. So Gop Kumar went back to Mathura, and he went to the birthplace, he went to Mathura Puri, the birthplace of Lord Krishna, and he was hearing Srimad Bhagavatam in the temple there from the Brahmanas, and then he went back to into the forest and he met his guru. And his guru gave him more teachings about the mantra, and then Guru disappeared, and then Gop Kumar met the people from Vaikuntha again. They came and they took him in the airplane, they took him to Vaikuntha. And they were telling Gop Kumar, we can give you a body with four arms like ours. But he said, no, 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 I don't want it. I just want to stay as I am. I'm a cowherd boy. So he was in the Vaikuntha airplane, and he passed over all the higher planets which he'd spent a lot of time visiting before. And he saw all the people from the higher planets, they were coming out and they were all offering their respects to him. They were, you know, putting their two palms together and raising them up in the air, offering respect to him, because they knew he's going to Vaikuntha, so they were praising him.
高等星宿的时候，之前他在那里，待了很长的时间。可是他这一回呢，他超越那里的时候呢，高等星宿的居民们都出来看望他，他们知道他要去Vaikuntha了，都出来向他顶拜，双手合十，并且把手伸到空中，然后并且对他大加赞许。And
on his way to Vaikuntha, they came through the abode of liberation, and he came also to the world of Lord Shiva, just above the abode of liberation, is the abode of Lord Shiva, and he met Lord Shiva again, Lord Shiva with his wife, Uma, and they were very happy to see him.
在回到瓦昆塔的路上, 他经过解脱之地, 之后, 他又到了主Shiva的地方, 主Shiva和他的妻子, Uma, 看着他都非常高兴, 祝福他。
So Gop Kumari bowed to Lord Shiva, and the Lord Shiva blessed him, and then Gop Kumar left, went on his way to go to Vaikuntha. And when he got to Vaikuntha, then he was told by the Vaikuntha Vasis, you have to wait here at the gate. We have to get permission from our Lord of Vaikuntha that we can bring you into his city.
然后，Gopakumar就顶拜了主Shiva和他的妻子，主Shiva和妻子非常高兴地祝福了他。之后呢，Gopakumar又继续前往Vaikuntha。当他到达那里的时候呢，他被告知要在门口稍候，他必须得到Vaikuntha的主人的允许，他们才可以带他进入Vaikuntha。And
they told Gopakumar, just stay here and be patient, and you will see things that you have never ever seen or heard about before.
他们告诉Gopakumar，你在这里稍候，耐心地等待，之后你就会看到你从未见过，并且从未听过的事情。
He would learn about the very special features of this place, Vaikuntha, which just beyond the imagination of people of this world. So Gop Kumar waited at the gate. They went inside to get the permission. And Gop Kumar, he saw people coming and going. He saw different vehicles, and they were coming and going, and there was music and entertainment, and there were people who looked like the Supreme Lord. They were very effulgent and very beautiful. And Gop Kumar was thinking, maybe this is the Supreme Lord.
人物还有各种各样的交通工具进进出出，有传来美妙的音乐，还有各种的娱乐，那些人看上去像至尊主一样光灿美丽。
Right. So he saw this person, you know, in four arms, very beautiful, and so Gop Kumar thought this must be the Lord himself. So he prayed, he called out to the Lord, oh my Lord, please protect me. And he bowed down before him. But the person just covered his ears and shook his head and said, no, no. He said, I'm not the Lord. I am a servant. I am a servant of the servants.
And
so then that person, he went into the city. He didn't need permission. He went into the city. So Gop Kumar was waiting there, and then another person came by who was even more powerful and more opulent. And Gop Kumar thought, this must be the Lord of the universe.
那个人说完之后就进城了，Gopakumar就在门外就等着得到允许。这时候又来了另外一个人，这个人更加有力量，更加富裕。Gopakumar心想， 这一定就是宇宙之主了。
And he thought this must be the Lord. He's coming. He must have gone somewhere. Now he's coming back. So he thought this was the Lord. But he should have known, actually, the Lord is not outside. The Lord was inside the city because the people went inside to tell the Lord and to get permission from him.
So
Gopkumar bowed down to him and offered prayers to him, but the person did the same as the other person. He covered his ears and said, "No, I'm not the Lord." And he went into the city. So while Gopkumar's waiting there, many people came. Some came alone, some came in pairs, some were in a big group. And they were all looking very very opulent, very wonderful, and they were entering the city of the Lord. They were all entering there into Vaikuntha. You know, they all had four-armed forms. Gopkumar is there with his two-armed form, but they've all got four-armed forms. So Gopkumar is thinking that this one is the Lord of the universe. And every time he bowed down and offered prayers, but they would always stop him and say, "No, I'm just a servant. I'm a servant of the servant. I'm not the Lord." But still, Gopkumar was very overwhelmed seeing how opulent and how attractive and how powerful they were. Some of them were carrying some of the different things for worship of the Lord. Someone had like a chamara, and like that, the chamara fan which we use during the RT. You know that yak tail? The white hair?
What?
Chamara.
Well, I don't know the difference between chamara and the yak tail. Yeah.
Well, it's the same thing. All the different people in Vaikuntha, they all were doing different services. They were all engaged in different activities for the service of the Lord. And they were all very happy. They were all in ecstasy doing these different services. Some were offering obeisances, some were reciting prayers, and some devotees, they were carrying different ornaments. And they were all glorifying the pastimes of the Lord, and the husband of the Lord Lakshmi, about, and they were glorifying the divine couple and talking about their pastimes. They sang and danced without any kind of restriction. All, it's like they're glorifying the Lord, and they were so happy, and it's like they'd been, they'd had, it's like coming home from a war. Everyone, when they win the battle, everyone is so happy. So they were like that. They were very happy, very glorious. And they were speaking about how the Lord is very kind to his devotees, how he provides everything for them, makes all arrangements for them. And some of them came with their families, they were coming with their families, and some of them were bringing many different articles with them, but some of them had no families, and some of them had nothing. It was all different. And some of them, they just brought all their stuff and left it at the gate of Vaikuntha. And some of them appeared like beggars without possessions. They came with nothing. But actually everything they had absorbed into themselves, but it wasn't visible. So you could see so much variety in relation to the service of the Lord, that people were all serving the Lord in their different moods. And because all the people of Vaikuntha have mystic powers, so they can change their form. At different times, they would take different forms. So, not only did they act in different ways, but they took different forms. Some of them would become animals, and sometimes they would become birds, and sometimes trees. So sometimes they show a form for some time, and then they change it into another form. Sometimes they would appear as a human, and then they would change to a monkey, and then they would become a demigod. And then they may change into demons or great sages. So they all have bodies which are spiritual, which are full of bliss and knowledge eternally. They don't have ordinary material bodies.
都拥有着灵性的形象，充满着喜乐、知识和快乐、永恒。他们并非有个物质的躯体。
So we cannot say they're human beings.Because they're not like human beings. Human beings, they take birth and die. They don't have bodies like that. In material world, human beings, they belong to different varnas and ashrams. They have different occupational duties and different positions in their spiritual life, like brahmachari, sannyasi, grihastha. But that's not there in the spiritual world.
有不同的职责，不同的地位，有的是身手生，有的是 sannyasi 托钵僧，还有的是居士，但是在灵性世界并没有这样的划分。
But sometimes they would appear like that just to give pleasure to the Lord, that some of them would wear sacred threads like they were initiated Brahmins, and they would be chanting mantras, worshipping the Lord.
展示的好像是属于这些阶层，只是为了主的快乐。有的呢会变成带着圣线的 Brahmana 唱诵着 mantra 崇拜主。
And some of them had tulsi mala around their neck and tilak on their foreheads, just like devotees. Actually, they're all devotees. They're all pure devotees, but they take these different forms.For the pleasure of the Lord.
还有的会带着 tulsi mala 净珠，或者是头上涂着 tilak， 好像是奉献者，但实际上他们都是纯粹的奉献者，都是为了主的快乐。
Sometimes some of them would look like Indra, whose body is all covered with eyes, and another time he'd look like.Chandra, the moon god, or some other demigod.
有的时候呢，一个人就变成了 Indra 的样子，浑身上下这长满了眼睛。过一会儿呢，他又变成了月神 Chandra 的样子，还有其他半神人的模样。
And some of them had three eyes, some had four heads, and many of them had four arms.
有的人长着三只眼睛，还有的人长着四个头，还大部分人都有长着四臂。
Some had eight arms, and some had 1,000 faces.
还有的人长着八个面孔，还有的人是有一千张面孔。
So for the service of Lord Narayan.The people in Vaikuntha, they can take these different forms of the demigods.
为了服务主 Narayana, Vaikuntha 的居民们可以变成半神的模样。
But they cannot become like Lord Narayan or like Ananta Shesha.
然而他们不能变得像主 Narayana 或者是 Ananta Sesa 那样的。
So, for the pleasure of Krishna, they can do all of these wonderful things. They can take all of these different forms.
为了 Krishna 的快乐，他们可以上演所有这些不同的活动。
In Vaikuntha, one type of liberty.Called Swarupya, and where you have the form like the Supreme Lord. So this is available for all the people in Vaikuntha. Okay. So,
I didn't catch it.
So in Vaikuntha, everyone has four arms, because this is the form of Lord Narayan. So this is a type of liberation, sarupya, having a form like the Supreme Lord. So why would some of them take human forms or even take monkey forms is hard to understand. We may think, you know, monkey body is not very beautiful, ugly body, the monkeys, but there are great devotees like Hanuman who has a monkey body. And then there's also Jambavan. Jambavan is a bear. He's also a great devotee. So bears are also not very beautiful, but Jambavan is a great devotee. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. That means one person may see something as very beautiful, and another person may see it as very ugly. It's a relative thing. So the people in Vaikuntha, they transcend the whole material world. There's nothing, it's not like the material world, it's totally different. It's very difficult to explain the realm of Vaikuntha with our ordinary words. So Narada Muni tell Gop Kumar, he said, you're from the material world, so your intelligence is limited to material, you're thinking in material ways.
Narada Muni tells Gop Kumar, you're from the material world, your intelligence is limited.
So when I describe things to you, I may say it's like this, but I'm just giving an example. But actually, it's beyond the mind and senses, because everything in Vaikuntha is spiritual. So, and when I try to describe Vaikuntha, I just give material examples to help you understand, but it's not exactly the way it is. It's not material, it's spiritual. Just like we may describe Krishna, we may describe the Lord of Vaikuntha as being like a king, but you know, he's not like a king of the material world. He's the king of, he's the Supreme Lord. He's much greater than any ordinary king of the material world. But the example of the king helps us to understand something about the king of Vaikuntha. So it appears that in Vaikuntha, some people are higher, on a higher position than others, but actually everybody is equal. There's only the equality between everyone.
好像是在百昆塔隐有地位高低之分，但实际上呢，一切都是平等的。
But all the residents of Vaikuntha can do anything they want. They all have that right, so they're all equal. They can change their forms at will, to any form they like.
他们可以把自己的形象转变成他们想要的任何形象。
And there's no envy amongst any of them. No one is envious of another. They're all equal.
在他们之间呢，没有任何嫉妒心，他们都是平等的。
And they never quarrel, and they never disrespect anyone.
他们从不争吵，也从来不会不尊重任何人。
And they're all humble and respectful, and they have friendly dealings with each other.
他们全都是谦卑的，尊敬他人的，彼此友爱。
So their qualities are eternal. They're not like the material world, which is a product of Maya. They're all eternal. The qualities they have are eternal. So it may appear like the people of Vaikuntha are sense enjoyers, like in the material world, people enjoy their senses. So people in Vaikuntha may appear like that, but actually they have no desire for sense enjoyment. These people are all worshipable by liberated souls. Even the liberated souls in the material world will worship these people, any person from Vaikuntha.
表面上好像是百昆塔的居民们像感官享乐者，但是他们并不是像物质世界的人那样，他们并不会没有感官享乐的愿望，他们。 值得物质世界的解脱灵魂崇拜。
Because the people in Vaikuntha, their life is just kirtan. They have a lot of kirtan, a lot of singing and dancing. So people say, no, this is maya, this is just sense gratification. You should get a job, you should work. And like people say like this to devotees. But in Vaikuntha, this is what people in Vaikuntha do. They just sing and dance all the time. They're very happy. It's not material, it's spiritual.
Vaikuntha的人们呢，总是在恒常的kirtan，他们唱歌跳舞，外人可以为这都是Maya，感官享乐，应该去找份工作，但是他们是奉献者，他们的行为就是Vaikuntha上的，他们是Vaikuntha的所作所为，就在那里唱歌跳舞，兴高采烈。 完全没有一丝一毫的物质，完全是灵性的。
So although they're singing and dancing, they're always in ecstasy worshiping the Lord.
他们唱歌跳舞，在狂喜当中崇拜主。
So they're fully engaged in devotional service. Their activities may appear material, but actually their acts are all spiritual.
他们是完全的从事着奉爱服务，他们的活动好像是物质的一样，但实际上他们的行为全部都是灵性的。
They're perfectly fixed in devotional service to the Lord of Vaikuntha.
他们完美的专注于对外昆特之主的奉爱服务当中。
But they take part in the Lord's pastimes, and they show all these different changes, and they're enjoying the pastimes of the Lord, and they're showing how much pleasure there is there in these pastimes.
他们参与到主的消时光当中，他们展示出不同的变化，就是为了表明在主的消时光当中会有多少快乐。
Nobody is forced to do anything he doesn't want to do.
没有一个人是被迫做他正在做的事情。
But they're controlled by pure love, and that causes them to act for the pleasure of the Lord.
他们是被纯粹的爱控制着，他们是为了主的快乐而从事着活动。
So, although everyone is equal, there's variety, and it appears like some person is better than another, but actually everybody's equal, but we see there's a lot of variety there.
那里的人人都是平等的，有不同的种类。好像是有高低之分，但实际上呢，全都是平等的，都是一样的。他们只是有不同各式各样的种类而已。
And this is all for the pleasure of the Lord, that the Lord likes variety, and he takes pleasure in these different activities with the different devotees.
这一切都是为了主的。主喜欢有各式各样的种类，他喜欢有不同的活动。
Everything there is spiritual, even the trees and the houses and even the airplanes which they travel around in, that these are all living beings who have taken these different forms for the service of the Lord.
那里的一切都是灵性的，包括树木、房屋，还有他们驾驶着的各式各样的飞机，都是生物变成的，都是生物他们变成的这样的形象，一切都是为了服务主。
So material world, you know, house, airplane, these are inanimate things, but in the spiritual world,They're not inanimate. In the spiritual world, these are all living entities who take this form for their service to the Lord.
在物质世界的房屋、飞机全都是死气沉沉的，没有任何生命。但是在那里的一切都是生机勃勃的，都是为了服务主而变成的那种形象。
Now, sometimes one place will appear like full of wealth, full of riches, valuable jewels like gold and different gems. But other places, everything will be like chalk, just white.
有的地方呢，展示出的是富丽堂皇的，都是由珠宝构成的，有着金子，还有宝石。但是另一个地方呢，一切都是白的，
So these things like gold and jewels are not so attractive to people in Vaikuntha. They don't mean much to people in Vaikuntha.
这百昆特像金子珠宝并没有很大的吸引力，百昆特的居民对此并不是很感兴趣。
We cannot understand Vaikuntha just simply by our material mind. We have to purify ourselves.
我们不能通过我们物质的心意去理解百昆特，必须要净化自己。
So we need to get the mercy from the Lord so that we can understand the nature of Vaikuntha. Because we are conditioned and we have impressions from this world, but we have to understand the spiritual world is very different from this world. We're not qualified to actually to speak about the spiritual world because we have not experienced it. We have only experience of the material world.
来讲述灵性世界，因为我们没有体验，我们拥有的体验全是对这个物质世界的体验。
We need to have direct experience to actually understand Vaikuntha.
要想真正的理解百昆特，我们需要有真实的体验。
So if we're conditioned, we may discover Vaikuntha, but we won't be able to understand it.
倘若我们是受限制的，我们会发现百昆特，但是却理解不了。But
if we desire to serve the Lord and we get instructions from the spiritual master and practice the teachings, then the spiritual master can recommend us so that we can gradually become pure and we can enter into the Vaikuntha.
如果我们想服务主的话，应该得到灵性导师的训示，并且按照灵性导师的教导去修行。这样呢，灵性导师就会推荐我们，逐渐我们得到净化，便能够进入百昆塔。So
just hearing is not enough. We have to become a disciple of a spiritual teacher and accept the discipline, and that will allow us to become self-realized.
我们光是聆听，单单聆听还不够，还需要成为门徒，接受灵性导师的训练，成为门徒，然后这样才能在灵修上呢受到训练。So
when we see the pleasure, when we see the nature of Vaikuntha, so whatever happiness is in Brahman is nothing, it's insignificant. Brahman appears almost like it's empty.
当我们看到百昆特的快乐本质的时候呢，Brahman变得微不足道了，就好像空荡荡的一样。So
people who are satisfied, full, they have no material desires, they've renounced everything, and they've associated with Vaishnavas. Then they can understand the difference. They can enter into devotional service.
一个没有任何物质欲望的人，并且弃绝了一切的人，通过跟 Vaishnava 的联谊，他们会理解这个区别，进入到奉爱服务中。
So Gop Kumar is anxious to have some other means to understand Vaikuntha, he wants to know what special faith is it that is required to do this bhakti yoga to enter into Vaikuntha. Some people may come through the impersonal path, that they have experienced something of Brahman and then they want to go on to realize Vaikuntha. They may come that way.
有的人呢,他们会走上这个非人格的道路,首先去体验Brahman饭,然后进而去理解Vaikuntha。
But if they do that, they have to leave, they have to be able to leave their knowledge of Brahman, that impersonal knowledge, they have to leave that behind to take up devotional service.
为了做到这一点,他们必须要放弃这些非人格的概念,然后接受奉献服务。
To actually take up devotional service, that this kind of Brahman, the happiness of Vaikuntha is so great that they see there was really nothing, there was no real pleasure in the Brahman. So Gop Kumar is still waiting at the gate and he's seeing all these different servants coming and going. So he's wondering, what kind of Lord must it be who has so many servants? All the servants seem so wonderful. What must the Lord be like?
Gop Kumar 在门口等候的期间，他看到这些进进出出的仆人都那么的奇妙非凡，他心想：啊，连仆人都这样奇妙，那么主人会是什么样子的呢？
So while sometimes he would stand up and then he would sit down and stand up again, sit down. Every time he saw different servants of the Lord come, he would think this is the Lord, and he would stand up and sit, and then he would realize, no, it's not the Lord. And so he was waiting like this for a long time.
他一会儿站起来，一会儿又坐下，一会儿又起立，一会儿坐下。 当他看见一个仆人的时候，他以为是主人，他便立刻起身。但是后来他被告知，哦，不是的，他就这样很长时间。So
the people who had brought Gop Kumar, they'd gone inside, so they came running back because the Lord did not want that Gop Kumar had to wait outside any longer. So they were anxious to come and get Gop Kumar and bring him into the city.
让 Gop Kumar 在那里等候的那两位人，他们急匆匆地跑回来，因为主，Vaikuntha的主人不希望 Gop Kumar 等的时间太长，他渴望让 Gop Kumar 赶紧进去。So
when he came in, there were more gates, one after another, and each gate there were good doorkeepers and and they would allow him to enter only after they would announce his arrival to their superior. Each gate, they had the same process. He had to get the permission from the superior to come in. So when he entered each gate, someone would be in charge, and Gop Kumar would think he must be the Lord of the universe. So he would bow down to them and offer prayers. But that they would tell him, you know, no, no, this is not the Lord, he's not the Lord, he's the servant, he's a servant of the servant. So finally, the Lord's devotees, they told Gop Kumar that there are special signs you will recognize the Lord. And they told Gop Kumar also what prayers he should recite and how he should observe the etiquette. Special signs on the Lord are things like the Srivatsa mark on his chest and the Kastuba gem around his neck. Otherwise, the Lord just looks like the same as all the other people there. They all have forearm forms, they're all very beautiful. And they taught him that when the Lord comes, then you have to bow down and then you keep some distance apart from him. Don't get too close to him. And join your palms together and look down at the Lord's feet and don't move. So after going through many gates, then finally he came to one place. There was a palace and it was just overwhelming. It was so wonderful. It's so much greater than any other place he'd been. And it was effulgent, and it captured all his mind and senses. And he could understand this is some very special place. On one side, there was this one big palace in the middle, and around the big palace, there were smaller palaces. So within the palace, at a distance away, he could see the personality of Godhead, the Lord of Vaikuntha. And he was sitting on a throne, a golden throne, and it was covered with jewels. It was very opulent. And he sat on a cushion, which was very white.
就在这个宫殿的正中央，就坐着Vaikuntha之主，他坐在一个黄金制成的宝座上，下面镶嵌着金光闪闪的珠宝，他坐在一个白色的坐垫上。
So he could understand this was actually the Lord of the universe. He was leaning, he was sitting on the throne. He was leaning on his elbow, and he appeared to be, you know, he appeared just like everybody else, because they all had the same form. But because he was sitting there on the throne like that, Gopkumar could understand, this is the Lord of the universe. And he appears, he's like a young man, he's not old, he's in his youth. Everyone there is in their youth. Vaikuntha is the nature of Vaikuntha, that they have these spiritual bodies, they're all young people. So he has a beautiful flower garland, and he's decorated with some ornaments and jewelry made of gold, covered with gems. Very opulent.
他身上佩戴着美丽的花环，佩戴着由珠宝和钻石所相串成的项链。
His forearms are long and well built, and he has beautiful, he has bangles and armlets, and his body is covered with yellow cloth. And beautiful earrings also swinging around his cheeks. He has the Kastuba jewel is around his chest, on his chest, around his neck, and there's also pearls around his neck, and his lotus eyes are full of life, glancing playfully at everyone. And he has his beautiful consort, the goddess of fortune, Ramadevi, by his side, and she's offering him pan for him to chew, and he's accepting it and chewing it.
在他身边是他的伴侣 Lakshmi Ramadevi. Ramadevi, 幸运女神在给他供奉着槟榔，让他咀嚼。主就接过了他递来的槟榔，放在口中咀嚼着。
So Ramadevi is equal to him in beauty and also in good qualities. So she's the ideal woman to be his consort. And Bhumi is also there. She's also the consort of the Lord, and she's on the other side of the Lord, and she's also serving him.
站在主的另一侧，他也是主的另一位伴侣，他在服侍着主。
Mm-hmm. Okay, so maybe we'll stop here. I mean, we'll ask if there's any questions.
好，那我们讲课部分到这里，接下来回答问题。第一个问题。 是一组喜宝。 Hare Krishna 顶拜咕噜， 我身边有一位奉献者姐姐， 为先生的离世做了那么多善法功德， 比如虔诚素食， 派发圣典， 圣名， 他的无神论家人 去请灵通人看过之后， 灵通人却说， 因为我们没有给亡者烧纸钱， 他现在缺钱。 更诡异的是， 通灵人在不知道亡者生前与一位活佛喇嘛有亲密关系的情况下， 居然说亡者希望喇嘛来帮助他。 这次亡者走得太突然， 为了能够全方位从Krishna之觉利益亡者， 我们没有通知喇嘛。 现在这位奉献者姐姐被这么多信息严重干扰， 请问Guru， 我该从哪方面帮助她呢？ 敬拜Guru， 翻译 Hare Krishna。
这个是谁的问题？
这个喜宝， 比方四川成都。 There is a devotee whose husband passed away. This devotee has done a lot of pious activity for this passing husband. For example, the vegetarian during the whole ceremony distribute scripture and holy names. His atheist family members has paid for a mystic person. This person said that because we haven't burned this paper money, the devotee's husband has no money and need money. Besides that, this person also said the passing husband hope a lama can help him. So now the devotee has been disturbed by so many information. I want to ask Guru, in which aspect should I help this devotee? By Krishna consciousness.
Well, the person should not hear from all of these kind of people. You know, if you hear from people like the lamas and these mystics, then you hear all kinds of superstitious things about burning money for the dead person and their future life, that they need money and you should burn the paper money. You'll hear all of this thing. This is all superstition. But you have to hear from people who are practicing pure spiritual life, and they can guide you better than just hearing from all of these different superstitious people.
他不应该听信喇嘛和这些什么通灵人的话，这些是迷信。 他们会让人去烧纸钱，说在他来生呢烧了纸钱他就有钱花了。他应该去听修习纯粹的灵性生活的人们来指导他，而不应该听信这些人的话，这是迷信。But
at the same time, I can understand that sometimes these kind of people, they have the respect of the common people. And sometimes you may have to go along with them, you may have to just satisfy them. And you may have to do these things just to satisfy the common people. Because not everyone is a devotee, not everyone understands devotional service. So they want to see you do the more traditional thing, like burn the paper money.
Maharaj, who respect ordinary person?
The common people respect mystics and these lamas and these kind of people.
Okay. The
common people, they don't know Krishna consciousness. They only know the lama and the super, these mystics there in Sichuan. You know, there's so many different mystics there. So they have respect for these people. They don't have respect for Krishna devotees. So sometimes you have to consider the public opinion, and you have to do things to satisfy the public. Although we would not normally do these things, sometimes just to satisfy the public, we do them.
有时候呢，为了让公众满意，让普通人满意，我们会，他们会这样去做。 一般来说呢，奉献者是不做这些事情的，但只是为了让普通人心里都感到些安慰、满足。有时候就是奉献者也会做一点这些事情。So
we cannot expect everyone just to take to the process of Krishna consciousness and totally give up everything else, give up all the tradition which they have there.
反正我们就是不能期望呢，人们一下子就全盘接受 Krishna 之觉，放弃一切，包括放弃这个传统。
So these are sensitive issues. When somebody passes from the world, people are concerned for the welfare of their departed relatives, and they want to do the best for them. So you may have to do sometimes these kind of things, and you do it, and then okay, then finish, we did it. You don't have to, and you certainly don't want to spend a lot of money to do these things. It shouldn't be a great expense.
所以有时候，有必要的时候就去做，那做完之后就结束了。 当然了，就是奉献者不想花很多的钱在这种事情上，这个开销不应该是很大的开销。But
if it's some simple tradition which they have, some very basic tradition, then you can go along with it just to satisfy people, to keep them quiet.
所以就简单的按照传统去做，去满足普通人，就让他们，不要就是胡说八道啊， 就让他们安静下来。
But if someone has very strong faith, then they may say, oh, I've already done everything, I've already done enough. We already gave away charity, we distributed holy literature, we gave the holy name. That's enough, that's very good.
倘若一个人他有强烈的信心的话，他会回答普通人说，哦，我已经做了一切了，嗯，我已经派发了圣典，已经给予了布施，派发了圣灵，这已经就很好了。
Okay, any other question?
下一个问题还是这个喜宝。王者离开躯体第一时间，我们邀请了已经启迪的奉献者为王者画了提拉克，嘴里含了 Tusi 叶子，脖子上戴了供奉过神明的花环。如果家属在太平间拿掉了这些圣物，会不会造成亡者对灵性回归的影响？如果通灵人说的亡者想请喇嘛帮忙，我们该怎么办呢？顶拜咕噜，这个事情的确考试太难了，请咕噜帮帮我们吧。Just after the relative passed away, we have invited the initiated devotee to paint tilak on the forehead and put tusi leaves into the mouth and flower garland around the neck. But if the relative has taken all that away in the room that put the dead body, will that affect this passing, the soul who has passing away affect his returning back to the spiritual world? If that mystic person said, want to ask the Lama to help, what should we do? So it's a very difficult issue. It's a business guru.Beg Guru to help us.
Well, like I said, these are sensitive issues. If some of the relatives are not favorable, if they want to have the Lama come and do something, then I don't know. It's a family affair. This is a personal affair. The family, they have the right to decide what kind of rituals they want to perform for the passing soul. So if somebody wants to bring the Lama, you may not be able to stop them.
我刚才说过，这是一个非常敏感的话题。如果他的亲属呢，就对 Krishna 知觉并不是很顺从的话，那他非要请喇嘛，这是他的个人的事情，是他的家务事，我也不知道。所以如果他决定非要举行一些仪式为这个去世的灵魂邀请喇嘛，那也无法阻止他们。
You cannot get too much involved in family affairs. It's the family have to decide these things. If you're an outsider, you have to be very carefulNot to get too much involved, and let the family decide it for themselves.
所以就是因为这是一个家务事，家里的人呢有权来决定这些事情，外人呢他要非常小心，不要卷入这些家务事，应该由这个家庭成员来做决定。
So if the person who wants to bring the Lama is more influenced, then okay, then you have to let them do it. And you can always offer prayers for the benefit of the departed soul. And you can just worship, you can offer prayers to Krishna on behalf of the departed soul, the person who died, for his benefit, and you can do welfare activity, you can do some charity for the benefit of that person.
如果那一定执意要请喇嘛，就是非常有影响力的喇嘛的话，那么就让他去做吧。与此同时呢，你们可以供奉祷文，代表这个亡灵向Krishna去供奉祷文，并且布施，做布施。
The soul, the person's already died. The soul is gone. So you can do some prayers for his benefit. And that will be very good. It's not that everything, you know. Everything depends more on the mood of the devotees. How you perform these things. But it's not so easy for the soul to go back to Godhead, but you can help him to get a better birth so that he gets an opportunity for devotional service.
灵魂呢已经走了，所以代表他来供奉祷文，对于这个亡灵是有好处的。这也取决于奉献者的心态，他怎样去做事情。
一个灵魂是不那么容易回归灵性世界的，但是呢，可以供奉祷文，帮助他有个更好的来生，在来生能够从事有机会从事奉爱服务。嗯，对呀，very good。Good day。那个这位奉献者有想问，就是如果他的家人。 为他做这些，就是喇嘛这些仪式的话，会不会对这个亡者有不好的影响，或者是跟我们这个 Krishna 直觉的这个做法有冲突呢
？No, it depends on the will depend on the on Krishna's desire, what Krishna wants, and what is the qualification of the person who's leaving the body. The soul, what is his desire? Where does he want to go?
不会的，这个依赖取决于 Krishna 的意愿。 Krishna 有什么样的想法，而且还要取决于那个离世的灵魂，他的资格，他当时有什么样的愿望，他在离开躯体那一刻，他的想法是什么？
You know, just because you want him to go back to God, if he doesn't want to go back to Godhead, but you're doing all these rituals, well, it will help him, it's for his benefit, but if he doesn't want devotional service, you know, we can't force him to take up devotional service.
您想他回灵性世界，可是他不想回灵性世界，所以您做这些仪式的话。 对他是有帮助的，有好处的。但是呢，如果一个人他不想从事奉爱服务，也不能强迫他从事奉献服务。But
your devotion to the Lord, that will be good for it. Will give him some benefit.
但是您的对主的奉爱会给他带来一些好处。
Will help him to get association with devotees to have the opportunity to do devotional service.
会帮助他得到奉献者们的联谊，使他有机会从事奉献服务。He won't
have to go into the lower species of life. He will be sure to get a human body in the next life.
他不会进入到低等的生命种族当中，他来世一定会有一个人类的出生。Okay. 下一个问题，来自热爱生命，顶拜 Guru，顶拜翻译，请问。 我们没有体验，所以没有资格讲述灵性世界一切。那我们是不是也没资格讲述物质世界的知识呢？因为好的东西也没有体验，何况又受条件限制，处在睡梦中，讲述的东西是不是胡说八道？现在如果没有清醒，只处在自己状态，按照自己的职责和前世的业报来修习自己，顶拜库尔莲花祖 Hare Krishna。 Obeisance to Guru. We don't have experience, therefore we don't have the qualification to speak about the spiritual world. Does that mean that we don't have qualification to speak about the material world also? Because we don't have experience also. Besides that, we are conditioned soul, we are sleeping, so we are speaking nonsense in our dreams. If we are not awakened yet, we are simply practice according to our duty and the previous karma. Hare Krishna.
Well, we do have qualification to speak about the material world because we have been living here in this world for some time, so we have experience.
我们是有资格来讲述物质世界的，因为我们在物质世界已经生活了一段时间了，所以对物质世界是有一段时间的体验。
And we've been hearing from the scriptures, we've been hearing about the different problems which are here in the material world. So we have our realizations about the nature of material life and the problem of how we are conditioned and how we make mistakes.
所以我们就以我们对于物质生活的本质以及问题是有着觉悟的，我们是受着条件限制的，我们会犯错误。
So we learn from our mistakes, and that these lessons can be valuable for other people.
我们会从中吸取教训，这些教训呢，对于其他人是个珍贵的教训。
So we explain according to our realization, according to what we've experienced in our own life. So there's nothing wrong in explaining everything according to your own realization.
Hare Krishna. 上面 Sumati Radha Madanji 还有一个问题漏掉。
对不起，漏掉了。来自于上面的是 Sumati Radha Dasi。顶拜 Maharaj 奉献者们，感谢主持。请问 ，Vaishnava 不想要四种解脱，不想要的四种解脱，是在哪个 loka？ 从对百坤的描述。The first part of the question is that Vaishnavas don't want four kind of liberation. Those four kind of liberation belongs to situated in which loka?
Okay, so a Vaishnava, they don't desire liberation, but if Krishna wants, if the Lord gives them it, they accept it and they go to the spiritual world and they will live in Vaikuntha. In Vaikuntha there are many different planets, many, many planets. According to the particular deity which we are worshipping, we'll go there.
Vaishnava 们 不欲求解脱，但是如果给主给予了解脱，他们也接受。他们去灵性世界百昆塔，在百昆塔有许许多多的星宿，根据他们崇拜的是哪一尊神像，他们去相应的星宿。
Just like Lord Kapila, he has a planet there, and his mother Devahuti is there, and the devotees of Lord Kapila, they can go there to be with Lord Kapila.
比如说，就 Kapila 在灵性白昆塔，他有一个星宿，他的母亲 Devahuti 也居住在那里，所以Kapila 的奉献者就会去那个星宿。
And Bhishma.He was always remembering Krishna driving the chariot of Arjuna as Partha Sarathi, the charioteer of Arjuna. So Bhishma went to that planet where the Lord has that form, where he is Partha Sarathi.
Bhishma, he remembers Krishna driving the chariot of Arjuna, the Arjuna driving the chariot of Krishna.名字就叫 Partha Sarathi， 他就是他是一个驾驶战车的车夫的形象，所以Bhishma 就去这个星宿。
So all the Lord's different incarnations, they all have their own planets there in the spiritual sky. Matsya the fish, Korma the turtle, and Varaha the boar.They all have the different planets in Vaikuntha.
不同的化身，比如说像 Matsya 鱼化身、Kurma 乌龟化身、Varaha 熊柱化身，在灵性天空都有不同的各自的星球。
So people who have devotion for these particular deities, they will go there to that particular planet.
对这些不同神祇，有奉爱的各自不同的奉献者，就会去相应的星球。The next part, from the description of Vaikuntha, 觉得这其中包含了出融入梵光的其他三种觉处。I feel that.It includes the other three kinds of liberation except merging into the Brahman. 那么昆的居民和南无居民不同是否只是在于主的情感关系上不同，奉爱的纯粹度是一样吗？ Then the Vaikuntha Vasi and the Braja Vasi, the difference between themonly lies in their rasa and the purity. Is it the same? The purity is it the same?
Yes, purity is the same. They're all the people in Vrindavan, Goloka, Vrindavan, and people in Vaikuntha are both 100% pure.They don't have any material desires.
是的，纯粹度是一样的。Vrindavan 和 Goloka 的居民，他们都是100%的纯粹，没有物质欲望的。
As you said, you're right. The difference is in rasa. That Vaikuntha, the rasa is servant, but in Vaikuntha and in Goloka, the rasa is higher. It's Madhurya rasa or.Friendship rasa, different, very different from Vaikuntha.
就像您刚才说的，就是他们是心态不同，不同的 rasa， 在 Vaikuntha 是仆人的 rasa 心态，在 Goloka 是更高的心态，比如说有 Madhurya 情侣，还有朋友的心态。
Vaikuntha is.All Aishwarya, very opulent. We were hearing about all the gold and how everything is so opulent. And, but Goloka Vrindavan is all sweetness and intimacy. It's Vaikuntha was so much awe and reverence, and Gop Kumar is bowing down and offering prayers, and he's told, don't get too close, stand back. But in Vrindavan, they're all embracing each other, and they're very intimate and friendly. So very different mood, Vaikuntha and Goloka.
那里展示的是艾什巴亚，就是富丽堂皇的，都是黄金铸成的，非常富裕的景象。那里的居民对主是怀着敬畏的心态，他们会顶拜主，心让祷文，而不要离主太近了，要远远的站在后面。而在瓦昆，在格洛克文达文呢，和主的关系是非常甜美的，亲密的。
他们会相互拥抱，像朋友一样交往，是这样的心态。啊，还有问题吗？下一个，
热爱生命，不对，下一个是唐继东，顶拜咕噜，你好，我听说槟榔有麻醉作用。 容易让人产生幻觉，这么说对吗？至尊主咀嚼槟榔是什么原因？Obeisance Guru, I heard that the pan is intoxicated. People will be illusioned. Is it right? So what's the reason for the Supreme Lord to chew pan?
Yes, we don't take pan ourselves. Prabhupada said we don't take pan, devotees, because there is some kind of intoxicating effect there. So why does the Lord take it? The Lord takes it for His pleasure. But He's not going to be intoxicated by it. The Lord's body is spiritual. He accepts the pan because it's made by His devotee. Just like we heard, Ramadevi, she personally grinds and prepares the pan for the pleasure of the Lord. So the Lord's duty is to accept the service of His devotees. And this is one of the services which He's willing to accept from the hands of His devotee.
奉献者不会去咀嚼槟榔，因为他有一些麻醉作用。然而主他是为了他的快乐而咀嚼的，因为主的身体是灵性的躯体，所以他不会麻醉，他会接受奉献者所做的服务，因为这个是 Rama Devi 亲手为主来研磨和准备的。 所以主他会愿意接受奉献者，亲手从奉献者的手中呢，来接受奉献者所供奉的服务。
We saw even Putana came offering poison to Krishna, and Krishna accepted her breast, although it was poison.
我们听说 Putana 他在乳房上涂上了毒液。 来给 Krishna 喂奶，然而主 Krishna 也接受了 Putana 的乳汁。So
we cannot imitate the Lord and His pastimes.
我们是不能去模仿主，也不能模仿主的消说。
If Krishna likes pan, all right, that's for Krishna, it's not for us. But when we offer pan to Krishna, then we don't take it, we distribute it, we give it to somebody else who is not following the regulative principles.
如果 Krishna 喜欢槟榔，那是 Krishna 的事儿。我们可以向 Krishna 供奉槟榔，之后呢，我们把它派发给。 The next one, Fang Huan Huan. 为什么我怕库马尔去灵运世界认不出至尊主呢？他是主纯粹奉献者，不是吗？有一天我们成为纯粹奉献者，有幸回到灵性世界拜坤的话，也会认不出主吗？请问该怎么理解？ So Gopal Kumar is the pure devotee. Why after he go to spiritual world, he cannot recognize the Supreme Lord? If one day we become pure devotee and return to spiritual world by Kunta, will we also cannot recognize the Lord? So how to understand?
Well, do you know how to recognize the Lord? Do you think, you know, just Gop Kumar, he saw these people, they have four arms, they have the beautiful features, they look just like the Lord, exactly like the Lord. Only just some small difference. You have to look very closely to see special features in the Lord. Like I said, there's this one mark on his chest, the Srivatsa mark. And there's this special jewel, this Kastuba jewel. You have to be able to look very closely. You have to be very expert. You have to be trained. Otherwise, you won't know which one is the Lord. So Gop Kumar hadn't had that training. But he got that training when he got there to Vaikuntha.
So, why did Gopal Kumar not recognize him? Because in Vaikuntha, the inhabitants of the mountain, their faces are all identical. You have to check very carefully. The Supreme Lord's chest has a Srivats mark. He wears a special Kastuba jewel. You 必须得非常仔细的来检查，这必须得受过训练，这个非常专业的训练才能知道。因为高帕库马他没有受过这个训练，他是去了百坤那之后他才被训练的。
He was from a cowherd family. He was only taught how to take care of the cows. They didn't teach him any shastra.
出生于牧牛郎之家，他被教导的是怎么去照顾母牛，他也没有得到有关于经典方面的训练。
OK。
下一个问题来自十三祖智敏，顶拜咕噜，个体灵魂应该把回到 Vrindavan 作为终极目标，还是？只是努力服务，恢复灵魂本性就可以。Obeisance Guru, the individual soul should make returning back to Vrindavan their ultimate goal, or only endeavoring for service, restoring their jiva nature.The nature as a soul.
There is no difference. Endeavoring for Vrindavan and restoring the nature of the soul, the same thing. Because the nature of the soul is to be the resident in Vrindavan or to be with Krishna. So there is no difference between the two goals.
这两个目标没有区别，回到 Vrindavan和恢复灵魂的本性，是成为 Vrindavan 的居民和 Krishna 在一起，这二者之间没有区别。
下一个问题。
下一个问题 ，Jagatish Bari Devadasi， 顶拜 Guru Dev， 感恩所有奉献者。Gopal Kumar 在修行道路上经过很多门。那我们不更艰难吗？还有在普舍特们月身体不舒服的话，也是 Krishna 给予的仁慈吗？请 Gurudev 指点，感恩 Gurudev。Obeisance Gurudev, obeisance to all devotees. Gopal Kumar has passed a lot of gates on his path of practicing. So what to speak about us will feel more difficult. Beside that, if we feel discomfortable in Purushottama month, is it also Krishna's mercy? So I beg for Gurudev's guidance.
Yes, the difficulties which we undergo, that is Krishna's mercy. We're very fortunate if you're having some difficulties, bodily discomfort, this is Krishna's mercy on you. To make it more challenging for you, you'll make more advancement in this way.
是的，就是在灵修路途上遇到困难，这个是非常幸运的一件事。这是一个仁，一份仁慈。如果我们觉得身体上有不舒服，这是Krishna的仁慈，他给我们挑战，让我们取得进步。
So devotee accepts this bad health and so on, Krishna's mercy on him to encourage him to increase his absorption in devotional service.
奉献者接受如身体不好、健康方面的挑战，这是Krishna的仁慈。 Krishna鼓励奉献者增加他们在奉献服务道路上的专注度。
This is our qualification to go back to Godhead. This is our test before we can go back to Godhead.
这是我们回归神首的资格，是我们回归神首道路上的考试。
下一个问题。
下一个问题， 陈冠江， Chaitanya Charan Das， 顶拜 Gurudev， 当我们弃绝家人从事Krishna知觉活动，我们可以做到不依附家人，可家人会因为这样而非常痛苦，有时候想到他们想不开、看不透、痛苦，我们也难受，应该怎样处理这问题呢？有人会说我们没感情，甚至奉献者也不理解。 Obeisance Gurudev, when we renounce our family member and engage in Krishna conscious activity, we don't attach to family members, but they feel very painful. If we think about how they misunderstood, they are in illusion, we also feel very sorry for them. So how to deal with this problem? Somebody will say we have no feeling. Even some devotees cannot understand.
Well, you have to consider your situation, how much are your family endeavoring for you, how much of an obstacle are they to your devotional service. Sometimes you can just pacify them by simply writing a few words. Sometimes that's enough. Sometimes you can just write some message or give some phone call and speak to them, and then they're pacified. They know you're okay.
您必须得考虑来衡量家里人的努力，他们给您造成了多大的障碍。您可以写信安慰他们，或者是发信息。 给他们打电话来安慰他们，告诉他们你一切都很好。
They cannot expect that you're going to be with them all the time. You have your own life. You have another brother there. Brother is there. He's taking care of them. They don't really need you. So you have to, you just have to continue your devotional service, and gradually they will understand that you've got your own life and that you're happy. You're doing what you like, you're happy. They should be happy to see that you're happy, that you have no problems, you have no anxiety, you have a good health. They should be happy. But if you go home, what good can you do? What can you do? You cannot do anything to help to improve their life. You can say that, you can tell them that whatever you're doing is for their benefit, and they will get great benefit from your devotional service. So you have to have faith in your devotional service, that your family members also benefit by you doing service to Krishna.
Obeisance Guru, how to give up bodily concept of life? How to renounce correctly relationship with relatives and friends? How to renounce false ego?
We simply have to engage in devotional service. You simply practice Krishna consciousness, beginning with hearing and chanting. Regularly hear the glories of the Lord from the scriptures and chant the holy name. The bodily conception is our false ego. So if you cultivate Krishna consciousness, then that false ego will be removed. And your friends and relatives, you don't need to renounce them. You simply try to tell them about Krishna give them Krishna consciousness. And if they don't want it, then they will renounce you.
只需要告诉他们 Krishna之觉， 如果他们不要 Krishna之觉的话， 他们就会弃绝您。
OK， 还有问题吗？
没有了。
OK， Hare Krishna， Sati， 我们今
Hare Krishna，
今天到这儿可以吗？
可以， 可以的， 我们今天没有问题了。
Harivansa
他不又提了一个问题。
OK，
最后一个问题。 到达灵性世界的任何一个星球或者是居所， 都是个体灵魂的终极目标， 或者是灵魂的本地居所吗？ 到达灵性世界的任何一个星球或者居所， 都是灵魂的个体灵魂的终极的居所吗？ 大概是这个意思。
Harivamsa Prabhu asked, is that any spiritual residence an individual soul goes? It's the ultimate destination of the individual soul. It's the, his own abode.
The ultimate destination of the individual soul is his own abode.
So an individual soul will go to a spiritual spiritual world.
Uh-huh.
Is it his ultimate goal?
Yes, right. That's right. We each have our own identity in the spiritual world, and we'll go back when we find our actual place, where we've actually come from, our original identity, then we will go back there, we'll be happy there.
是的，就是每个灵魂都有自在灵魂世界都有各自的身份，是他们真正的地方，他们是从那里来的，是他们原初的地方，他们在那里就是最高兴了。
So sometimes people, you know, they may not initially find the right place, but if it's not their own place, then they won't feel comfortable there. They want to move to another place.
一开始，个体灵魂可能去的不是他真正的地方，在那里他会感觉到不舒服，他就会移到下一个地方。
We'll hear about this, Gopkumar is trying to find his place, and so he's traveling, visiting all the places, and we'll see how he's not so satisfied in each place until he comes to his actual place.
我们在后面将听到Gopkumar他努力地寻找他属于他的地方，他拜访了不同的地方，有的地方他感到很 Some place he feels very satisfied.
Yeah, when he comes to his actual place, his original place where he belongs, then he understands this is his actual home, this is his original home.
当他到了那个属于他的地方的话，他就会感觉到，哦，这是我真正的家，这是我原初的家。
And then he'll want to stay there.
那时候呢，他就会愿意待在那个地方。
Just like if we go to Vaikuntha, but we're meant to be in Goloka, then we won't feel so happy. We'll hear about Gopkumar. He goes to Vaikuntha. He's not so happy in Vaikuntha. He wants to go some other place.
比如说呢，一个个体灵魂去了百昆特，可是他原初的地方应该是狗洛克。 坤特他会觉得不那么开心，就像格瓜库玛他去了百坤特，他并没有感到非常的高兴，他那时候就心思呢就想要去别的地方了。
Okay, so we'll hear about all that and as we go through this chapter and the next chapter.
我们讲到下一章的时候就会谈到这个话题。Next, there's a more question, another question.
From who?
Chanchala Devadasi.
Oh, what does she want?
请问 Guru 用破的念珠带啊 ，How to? She wants to ask how to deal with the old torn japa bag.
The old torn japa bag. Well, you can give it to someone as prasadam, or you can simply throw it away.
嗯，您可以给别人当成 prasadam 送给别人，或者是只是把它扔掉。
Get a new one.
然后你去找一个新的。
Do you need a new bag? Does Chanchala need a new bead bag?
那 Guru 问 Chanchala Devadasi, 您是不是需要一个新的念珠袋？
他没有回答。
是的，没有回答。
OK， 是这个吗？你好，没问题啊。
对，没有问题的，不对。
好，
这是我们最后一个问题。
我们结束吗？
好的，我们到这里结束。
好，感谢方先生，感谢 Guru Mani 给我们那么好的翻译，感谢萨提主持。感谢所有的奉献者聆听，祝福你们。Purushottam Yuakwaila， 灵性的进步。Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai。Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。好，那我们今天早课到这里。